Alright, welcome back to another Valheim video. Today, we're gonna start off by doing the second boss. And first of all, I obviously updated my base. you can see how many wolves I killed. Each one of these is literally four wolves. Besides the two-star wolf that I killed, the rest are just no stars. So well, let's see here. We got 4, 8, 12, 16, 20, 24, 20. About 23 wolves killed since the last video, and I killed them all right here. And oh, I also extended my property out. It used to end right here. I extended this out for more room, got my garden up here, and I actually had another idea to put it over here or another one. Speaking of wolves, you can hear them already. They're right up over that little hump every time I go up over there. And I actually decided, you know, I'm gonna go exploring up there, I'm gonna see how big this mountain is. And so I put a bunch of campfires all the way up there, and I found this dragon egg. So I definitely brought that back to my base because I need this for the fourth boss, I do believe. I need three of them. So now that I know there's a spot up there, I can go and just get them. It'd be really interesting to go all the way up here to see if the fourth boss is here. Because if that's so, I'm set. Like, I picked the perfect spot. And as I showed my map a second ago, I did some exploring. I wanted to see how big this area is for me. So down here, starting area, got another mountain over here. Walking along this coast, this just ends right here. It's just a skinny land part. I had to burp. Oh. Anyways, right out here, I got like two or three other mountains, so really excited to get my boat ahead over that way. And ironically, I got a river right here, so even though I'm on this lake, I got a river out here, river, 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 so on and so forth. Yeah, so expanded my base. I got one of the fermenters up. I'm planning on getting like three, four more. I got my bees. Now, if you're wondering how you get the beehives, you go around to these abandoned buildings, so just like this thing over here. And I'm so glad this is here for an example. If you walk up to these types of buildings that are already there, out in like, not the snowbound, but like out in the regular forest, as you get closer to it, you can hear like the bees buzzing. And all you do is like, I get my bow out and I'll sit here and shoot them. And for me, it's just one arrow. You destroy the hive, some honey drops, the queen bee drops, and that's when you need to craft these. And yeah, I got three of them. Stepping in the fire. But I need honey to make all like the minor healing, poison resistance, minor stamina, tasty thing. There's a forgot what I gotta kill or get to the frost resistance potion, but I think that's up in the swamp. So we're gonna go kill the second boss, and I'm gonna make the boat right away, and I'm gonna go out and try to find a swamp. So other than me expanding my base, you know, getting the dragon egg, oh, I got the portal up, so I don't have to walk there. I didn't really do anything. I just, you know, expanded my base. I got like new bow tools. I mean, I upgraded them. Upgraded my crafting bench, both of them, the bench and the forge. That's about it. Oh, and this down here. I can't remember what video it was that I said I was gonna do this, but I decided to make stairs all the way down here, building a canal. So I got the canal over there. Kind of forgot that there's only so far in the ground that I can go. So until the game literally stops, you can't go deeper. So I can't make the canal all the way up to here, which is what I wanted. So it's probably gonna be like half the length of what you can see there, probably less. But we're gonna get onto that eventually. I'm just gonna put my boat. Actually, I'm gonna dig out like that last little part where you see like where I started digging at. I'm gonna dig it down to there, so I can actually put my boat inland. So like when it storms, my shit doesn't fly away. But we're gonna get into it. So I got all my food, my arrows, need the thing to summon it. This is right here. I'm just gonna put that right there. And we're just gonna get into it. Now, when I killed the first boss, I did mention that we fight the second boss the same way, just about bow and arrow. Well, you do it a little bit differently. What you want to do is you want to trench off this middle platform. The reason for that is because the main boss spawns there, and he can now not escape. So, I can sit here and just hide, like, in my trench, for example, and behind trees. Actually, that is one thing I needed to do, so I'm going to do that really quick. Alright, so I'm over here setting this stuff up, and I got a troll just coming out of nowhere. This guy wants to act tough. Don't think so, bud. I'm on the little island, and you can't get to me, so you're just gonna stand there and take damage. This is actually pretty good, so now I can upgrade my troll armor, too. By a troll forever in the pit. Yeah, so now we're back. I forgot about some of his attacks, so he's gonna be using range attacks on me, normally not stone trees, so I just cut down all the trees that are right here. These ones might fall on me, but you know, I'll see it coming. So we're gonna get into it now. Second boss fight. Run back over here. Oh, don't tell me you're spawning on the outside. No, no, no. Please fall in the trench. Fall in the trench. Oh, is he in the trench? Okay, I might have to go on the middle for this. Didn't make it wide enough, unfortunately. Yeah, there's his rage attack. Standing behind my invincible wall. Stand behind this. As you can see, those trees are just falling. That's it. Fucked myself a little bit. Walked out at the wrong time. These vines coming up. And I'm gonna move my position. And the trench cannot hit me. I use this pillar and just shoot him. Remember correctly, this guy does regen health, so you do want to be doing damage to him. Also got the burning arrows on him, so he's always taking damage. Sam, get back. Continue. That guy really does not like my hut. He knows my teleporter is there. But it's okay. I can always rebuild it if he destroys it. As you can tell, that this boss fight is just an endless game of peekaboo. Ooh, what in the Harry Potter you doing over there? Pull some Michael Jackson. He's got the vines back up. I'm gonna move from this spot. Hide behind my wall again. Definitely just hit that rock. Damn's going back up. Peek again. So I'm moving forward. You can see me. My vines are back. Let that arrow rip. I don't remember if headshots do more damage, but instead of like missing 80% of the time trying to hit his head, I'm just going for center body. Because I know I'm going to hit him every time. Won't be long now, he will die. I do recommend before you fight this guy that you get the fine wood bow instead of the one that I'm using. I think I upgraded this thing. Yeah, I upgraded it once. Definitely get the fire arrows. That little bit of ticking over time does make a difference. I could have just let him burn to death, but hey, it's all good. And now that this guy is dead, we get the swamp key and his trophy. Now let's say you wanted to hang up his trophy inside your house. You could do that, all you have to do is kill him again. But if you want his ability, you gotta go back to the main area. Which I do need to make a teleporter from my base to the main area, because unfortunately, I can run all the way back there now. I don't even think I have the, yeah, I don't have the wood for it. So two of these Sirdling cores is what you need to make the teleporter, 20 fine wood, and I believe it's 10 of these eyes, so I'm actually too short. I hear a wolf, he's close. Yeah, I see him, there he is. Oh, I aimed way too high. There we go, dead wolf. Okay. I can drop that, and I can drop that. That's just more important. Shit, I didn't realize I had these. Those. Oh, I forgot I made another, yeah, right here. I ended up getting so much meat I had to make two chests, cooked meat and non-cooked meat. Oh, wrong spot. Alright, I'm going to make this teleporter and head down to the main base. I'll see you guys in just a moment. Alright, so this happened. I have a troll decided to run over to me. So instead of mining this copper, I'm just gonna have him smack the rock for me. Oh, come on, you can hit the rock. You're doing it before. Yeah, there we go, there we go. Keep doing that. What I need. Come on, do the power fist. Power fist me. Not literally. Just, you know, hit the ground. Oh, come on. You were doing it when I wasn't recording. There you go. Alright, you need to move over here. Alright. You good? Smack the rock. Oh, come on, dude. I don't want to sit here and kill you. I want you to mine for me. There you go. Thank you. Yep, keep doing that. Keep doing that. Exactly what I need you to do. Do it again. Do it again. Yep, there you go. You're doing good. Walk over here. Do it right here. Yep. Just keep doing that. Come on. Oh, that does it, like no damage. Yeah, there you go. I was fucking smacked. Oh, you dick. Thought too fast for you. Yeah, that's right. You wanna smack the rock? How to train your troll 101. Now you're gonna burn it up. Yep, that is how you mine. Get a troll. We are back, and instead of making a teleporter, I was like, well, I gotta make a boat anyway, so I'm just gonna make that. And here we go. Boat was all good to go. We're gonna go across this lake. We're gonna discover the ocean too at the same time we get further out. Hopefully, I don't come across a sea serpent right away. Pretty sure I can kill it with this bow. I mean, all I have to do is go back to land and then I can kill it, get all the stuff from it. So if you kill this thing out here, everything's just gonna sink and you never get it. Unless you like drop everything on you and I don't know. I don't think you'll be able to get it back from out here. Now this lake might be too skinny to call it an ocean. Kinda forgot that. You know, this is metals over here on the left and right. Stretches out in the water. Definitely need to fix that. Alright, now we are against the wind. Just kind of clearing out my map right now as I go down here. I'm gonna sail back up this way as well, because instead of setting the teleporter from my base to down here, I'm gonna set a teleporter to the swamp. So when I find one, I can just teleport to it. Alright, now I got the wind. Almost there. I cannot wait until I get the nuts boat because that one's so much faster than this one. Go to half sail. Put the sail up to decrease the speed. basically neutral. So coast on in. I'm gonna reverse it for a second. Yep. Now I'm going to go put this down. Oh hey dear, I needed you earlier. Hey birdie. Alright, get the trophy up there. Alright, now I'm just gonna chop down some birch trees and go back to base real quick. And I will see you guys there. Alright, so I'm back at base, and I'm just gonna show you guys this real quick. So these, like, lettering that's on the teleporter, you want that facing away from a wall. Or wherever you're putting this on. Like, you want that facing you, so when you walk out of it, that's the direction that you're coming from. So, place this down, and I'm gonna select a tag, and I'm gonna name it Swamp. Now, this is how you connect your teleporters. So when I put my next one down, and I name it Swamp, it's going to be connected to this one. Now, with this one, I have it named Second Boss. So the one that I have over at the Second Boss, I also named it Second Boss. And that's with the space in it too. If I didn't put the space, these wouldn't be connected. So everything's got to be exactly the same for them to work. And that's just how teleporters work. Now, as I stated a couple videos ago, items with this red X on it, you cannot teleport with those. It will not let you teleport at all, so you gotta walk back. It's really annoying, but we're getting there. Alright, we are back in the boat, and we are heading to this river right here. I wanna go out this way first, because there's a couple mountains literally right here. I wanna check out around that island. Hope there's a swamp right there as well. If that's the case, I'm gonna have like four, two, three mountains right there, plus a swamp. Pretty big. So, we're gonna get over here. Oh, the wind change is good. Real quick, just because I'm right here and I like this. I like to clear up my map. So, it's gonna clear this little bit out real quick and then head into the river. Alright, there we go. Onwards! Real quick, I will say this is one reason why I do clear out my map before I go out and do stuff, because I do like to see like where stuff's at, where I can go, all this other stuff. So, you know, like right now, if I didn't clear out my map over this way, I wouldn't have known that this river was here, and I wouldn't know about these mountains over here either. So, or if you're a new player, I do suggest like clearing out your map in the area they're at, see how big the land that you're on before you have to go out and onto the water and do more. Another thing I will say is, so I have not gone up and down this river yet in a boat, so I could have my sail all the way down, but I don't know what kind of rocks and the shallow parts are. So first time I go down a river, I always I don't have my sail down, I just have it at one speed. I'm always zoomed out all the way so I can see where all the different rocks are at in the river. Because if you do crash into a rock, your boat does take damage over time. And you need a crafting bench to repair. So, first time down the river, even though I'm like my way back through until I remember where like everything's at in the river, I just go up the space. But like once I know the river, you know, I'm fucking full sail. Full speed all the way down, I know when to stop and all that other stuff. So, there is the mountain, I do believe. Yes, it is. Coming out on the other side of the river, we can see the mountain. That is where we are heading. So, I will see you guys right over there. Oh my god, I saw that redfish and I thought, oh my god, really? A serpent already? I just entered the ocean. Real quick, because I am still crossing this. That is the mountain that my base is next to. Like, that is an absolutely massive mountain. Like, I'm really glad that I decided to build my base over there, because that's going to last me so long with silver and all this other stuff. Unfortunately, there's not a swamp right here, so I'm just going to continue around it, and if I make it all the way around without a swamp, continue to the next area. So, here we go. It's just a very long process of discovery. So, when I get around the island, I will see you guys then. And just real quick, so, still, like, I've only been traveling for like 20 seconds after I cut the video. There's my mountain back there, kind of hard to see. Here is the other mountain in front of me that I saw when I was walking along the edge over there. Another massive mountain. Now, this one in front of me, definitely bigger than the one that I am next to. That thing is huge in height. I'm gonna have to get closer to it to see how long it is, but in terms of height, like, fourth boss might be up on this mountain. Just saying. Now, I won't know that for sure until I get, like, the frost resistant potions or the wolf cloak, whatever it's called, wolf cape. Just gives me enough warmth to go up on the mountain without the potions, but still going. No swamp in sight yet. Gonna keep it going. Alright, we are back, and this tree is in the way, but we got a swamp right in front of us. Now, this is the first island I was around, the big boy mountain, right here, marked on my map. We got a swamp directly in front of us. So, I'm going to just go around this bend right here. We got another mountain right over there. That was going to be my next section to go to if this wasn't here. Oh, and this might be a false swamp. We just got one tree. Oh, that is so disappointing. I saw that tree. I was like, shit, I'm gonna get my video back up and going. Entering this area. Please tell me it's just like a little bit further ahead past these trees. That is so upsetting to see. I'm gonna keep going because I can't see what's right here in front of me. It has so much of this green stuff on it, too. I forgot what I need that green stuff for. I know I need it for something. I just can't remember what it is. So, we're just gonna keep going. Of course, it's becoming nighttime. You know, we're technically in the swamp. It's raining. I might dock my boat here and make a bed real quick and just sleep through the night. Yeah. So that. Ooh, what the fuck? Where did that come from? Alright, anyways, I hope we can get a swamp here soon. Because I don't want to go, like, too far from my base. Because I gotta carry all this iron ore back. That's the only part that sucks about this. So we're going to stop right here. I only got one monitor, so I want to stop my boat first before I continue. And pause the video. Okay, there we go. Alright, if I'm not mistaken, that building in front of me is a yep, plains. Okay, so we found the plains before we found the swamp. And we found another big mountain right in front of us. So, I've got to make sure I don't come across a mosquito here, because it will fly out here and just kill me. And by kill me, I literally mean one-shot me. And there we go. Planes. keep our distance. I don't think this bow is fast enough to get away from a Duskito, and there's one right there. That little bugger right there. Let's steer clear of you. Ain't no way you see me. Stay over there. Turn the boat. Got another Duskito right there. Just wanted to get the basic outline of this. That way I can see it on my map, that I know it's here. So I'm gonna go around this, and I'm gonna cut across to there if there's not a swamp to my right. So I actually hope there's not a swamp to my right, because a swamp on the edge of a plains is deadly as shit. Helping the swamp get attacked by a Duskito and die instantly. Think that I used to, like, on my first world, I never had to travel anywhere by boat. My main land that I was on was so large that ooh, there's the swamp. Going to the other side of it, though. Fuck the plain side. But, the main island that I was on was so large, I had everything there. It was amazing. Like, I had, like, a couple rivers that I had to cross, but they weren't, like, that big. So, I had the swamp, plains, mountains, everything. Every terrain was connected to the mainland. It was amazing. Oh, there's a Duskito right there. So, first thing I'm gonna do, I hope this isn't another false swamp. I do need to have tombs here. There's not any tombs in this one. I gotta go to a different swamp. Judging by the size of it so far, I don't know if there's gonna be a tomb here. We might. We might. This is definitely more than a swamp than the last one, you know, the single tree. Just looking into the trees, see if I can see anything. Looks like the swamp ends right up ahead too. So it's not a big swamp. I am not seeing a tomb anywhere. It's actually really upsetting. Might have one up ahead, or it's an abandoned building. Might have to go find another swamp. So yeah, it's an abandoned building, not a tomb. So that swamp is a no-go. I'm gonna keep, I'm gonna go straight for a little bit more. See if there's another swamp up here. This is very interesting. I've never seen these pillars out here on little tiny islands before. Or one of these buildings. This one's built different. They are out here. Living on small islands. It's insane. Oh, I'm gonna turn the other way. I'm gonna keep going straight. You don't see me. There would be a Duskito. Oh, there's a swamp. Okay. And just so you guys know, I just cut straight across. I came across another plane. I was like, ah, I see some flatland out there. Let me head out that way. More planes. And a swamp. This one actually looks bigger, so that's really, really good. Ain't no way in hell there's not crypts here. Yeah, this one is massive. Who knows, the third boss might be here too. Two Duskitos on a small island? Nah, staying clear of that shit. Potion slowly. See what I can see from here. I just remember the slimes and all this other shit that's here. Draga. Probably just said that wrong. You can hate me for it in the comment section. Right. If I'm seeing correctly, there might be one right over there. I gotta hope that there's not planes on the other side of here, because I need to make a base. And rather than do it right in the swamp. I always like to do it on like the outskirts of it. Alright, so yeah, we got one right there, crypt. So, we are going to be going into the swamp. And it looks like more planes. Please, God, don't be. Oh, we got planes on the other side. Where's a good spot for me to make a base here? I don't want to do too close to the plants, because I don't want to deal with the Duskito. Get out of here. Leech. Attack my boat. I'm going to be making that right here in front of me. Got a couple trees here, so that's good. I'm gonna get set up here and I will be right back. I'm back. No, I did not die. I got my teleporter down. Before I even got like three walls up, I had already gotten attacked by like four or five of the Draugr, bunch of the fucking leeches, like a tier 2 leech. Like, what the fuck? I haven't even built my base yet. So, I got my teleporter down, came back here. I'm going to get a lot of fucking wood, and I'm going to head back over there. So I will see you over there. We are back, and we're going to go to a crypt. So, now I gotta find one that's close to me, and start with that one. For a second, I thought that was the boss area, but then I remember it's literally a giant skull. So you'll see when you... Oh, God. Not you. Well, how did that mess get out of here? Fucking blobs. Saints will poison you. Gotta keep your distance, shoot him with an arrow. Should really get some poison resistant potions made. Leech, I'm not worried about you. How did that miss? Oh, come on, game. I'm aimed right at him. Now the hoe is really, really good in a swamp. Don't want to go in the water because there's a bunch of leeches. You just hoe your way around. Yeah, those are the plains. I do not want to go that way. Really don't want to go this way. But I'm going to have to destroy whatever spawners over here. Surprise attack, bitch. You're dead. So we are going to get rid of that. That was two of them there. How many arrows does it take? There we go. Gonna get my stand back. Hopefully with destroying these, they don't spawn back. I'm hoping that they don't. There's another one over there. I'm gonna go back and get more arrows eventually, shit. Oh, come on. There we go. Is that the last spawner? It is. Good. Chest. Hey, arrows. Ironhead arrow. That's really good. Alright, there's my first crypt. Let's get over there. Oh, we got one of those guys at the front. Ain't no way, game. Thank you. Burned to death. Alright, let's go inside here. Time to get iron. Now comes the real challenge. So there's nothing over here. Fantastic. Love it. Oh, there's a blob in here. Nah. 9 million years, bud. Just give it a second. I'm out of his range to hit me. There we go. Now surprise attack. Fuck it, he's not moving. Of course, every spot I have to go underwater. believe I need these big bones for the boss. Yeah, I do. Alright, so I guess there's only one way, and it's this way. This better be a big area, because I'm already disappointed. Alright, we got some iron. Good thing about this is it's easily to get rid of it. I don't know what's on the other side, so I'm gonna work on one corner. Alright, blob right away. Shoot that from this distance. Oh, you dickhead, come back. Burn to death, come on. Damn it. Right. I can remove all of this. Work on this side. Good, there's a lot of iron in here, that's really good. This is the point where the game begins, in my opinion, in terms of gear. Okay, just gonna work on that one corner. I don't think anything's in here. No, it's not. Ooh, 11 iron. I forgot you can find it in the chest in here. That is huge. Alright. Hey, and the boss. It is. Ooh, it is not far from here. That is really good. Now all I gotta do is, find that merchant with the belt to carry more weight. That comes in handy a lot when doing iron. So this way is a dead end. Just gonna follow this best I can. Go down this way next. Got a bigger chunk here. Really good. Alright, looks like we got nothing else in here. Mob wise. Maybe? Yeah, we're good. So I am overweight. I'm gonna go back. Just gonna put all this iron that I got into the chest that I have. Oh shit. That's not Odin. Oh come on, game. Coming. Oh, you're gonna burn to death. Yeah, there we go. Give me your chain. Oh, wait, I can't pick it up. Fuck. There we go. Alright, now I'm just gonna run back over here. Okay, there we go. Like, where did I hoe my way across? Definitely went the wrong way, but hey, we're good. What the? What's down there? Oh! I know what that is, and I'm running away. Ain't happening, big boy. Nope. Not dealing with you. Teleport. Oh, shit, though. Let's put all that stuff away. I'm just down to iron arrows. I'm gonna go through my teleporter before it aggro's over here. I'm just gonna stockpile back on arrows, and I'm gonna head back over there. Alright, we're back. We're attacking this thing. It can't come over my wall. I'm just gonna attack it nonstop. Pretty sure you get like a trophy and something else from this thing. Please tell me you're going away. Oh, you're coming back, aren't you? I'm not too sure what the fuck he's doing. Yeah. What are you doing? Yeah, he's coming back over. I'm gonna run back inside. Shut that. Back it on up. Don't attack my boat. No, you're a dick. My boat! Alright, I need to repair that wall. Oh shit. Oh, my teleporter, no! You were a dick! Fuck you! I'm going out this way. My boat! Why couldn't you be good the first, like, the first time? Don't you do any more damage. God, I hate this thing. Beautiful boat. My wall. I'm gonna have to dig a fucking trench somehow. Oh, now you're gonna. Okay, fuck you. Destroys my boat. Destroys my wall. I can see the fucking dust over there. Well, at least now I can face my boat the other direction. Such a dickhead. About to be just putting layers and layers of. Okay, I thought I went through all my arrows for a second. But about to be just putting layers and layers of walls just for that reason. Like, shit. Okay, I started my recording a little bit late, but the abomination was literally right there. Kept running and running and running away from me. I finally killed it. It's gone. It's dead. It left the swamp. Either I killed it or got hit by a dusky and died instantly. So, either way, it's dead. Fuck it. Ain't no way that thing's still alive. Oh my god. I thought it died. Fuck you, bud. Oh, you're not even close to dying. It faked me out. Running away. That would be one star. Oh, the screen shake is intense as shit. Swim. Swim. Not running back to base, just flatter ground. Definitely need to kill this guy. Back to killing this thing. Fuck off, skeletons. You aren't here. You know, for a big scary monster, you run away a lot. Damn, that thing's out in the plains. I don't know what a... I feel about that. Hey, buddy. I've never seen one of these leave the swamp before. Oh my god, and he's attacking those guys. Oh, they killed him. Those little bastards are strong as shit. I'm gonna do it. Oh, okay, this might be bad. I don't know what his health's at. Yeah, that's really bad. Where are you going? Alright, it's only one. Come here, little bitch. You're not gonna hit me. Oh, he hit me! Dickhead. Fucking little laugh. No, you're not running. Come attack, you dickhead. Woohoohoo! Fuck you! Give me the black metal. Yeah! Alright, I need to get over here and get this thing. Oh, there's a couple more, and he's got a fucking. Oh my god, where'd they go? I'm out of here. Oh god. If I remember correctly, that one throws spears and they fucking hurt. Fuck you. Alright, what's down here? No.
No!
You keep shooting that wall, bitch. Get fucked. Oh, this is all underwater? What the fuck? Alright, going back to the grip. Before any more weird shit happens. Alright, so I cleared out the whole crypt, got all the iron, just to show you, I got 68 iron, pretty good for my first haul out of one place. So I'm going to go all the way back to my base, get this all smelted out. I'm gonna end the video right here. I've gone past my hour mark, which I'm trying not to do for these videos. So, as always, like the video, subscribe. See you in the next one. Appreciate it.